What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about creating the new Microsoft Teams package within SCCM. Yes, SCCM. So let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is download the new Microsoft Teams application, which I already did. I dropped it into this UNC path, and I'm going to copy that path because we're going to use it pretty soon. And there goes our MSIX file. Beautiful. So we're going to open up our Configuration Manager console. From here, we're going to go into the Software tab. From here, we're going to open up the Application Management folder. I'm going to open up Applications. And depending on how you got everything set up, well, for me, I have everything broken down to vendors. So I'm going to go into the Microsoft folder. I'm going to right-click on the folder, and I'm going to select Create an Application. Awesome. For the type, we're going to click on the drop-down menu and we're going to select Windows App Package. Beautiful. And then I'm going to paste the UMC path as well as the name of the MSIX file. Got it? Cool. We're going to click Next here. You're going to get a nice little view imported information, which is green. Awesome. We're going to click Next here. Now, for the general information, make sure you check off provision this application for all users on the device. Check it off. Make sure you do that. Click Next. A nice little summary. Click Next. It's going to start doing its thing. Give it some time. You're going to get a green check mark that it completed successfully. Awesome. So click on Close. Now, select your new application. We're going to right click on it. We're going to select Distribute Content. We're going to click on Next here. Next again. Click on the Add button, select Distribution Point, select your DP, click OK, click Next, nice little summary, click Next, and you're done, and then close it. Now, I'm going to deploy it, so select your application, so we're going to right-click on it and select Deploy, click on Browse. As soon as you click on Browse, it's going to take you to the User Collections. That's not what we want. So click on the drop down and we are going to select device collection and then pick your collection. I'm going to push it out to my Windows 11 machines. Click OK. Click Next. I don't have to do anything here. Click Next. For the deployment settings, for the purpose, it's set to available. Yeah, you can leave it as is. But for this, you know, for this video, I'm actually going to change it and I'm going to click on the drop down and do required and click Next here. For scheduling, I'm going to leave it as the default. Click Next. For the user experience, I can't really tell you how you want your users to experience this, but I'm going to leave it as the default. But once you make the changes, click on Next. Alerting, I'm not going to do anything here. Click Next. Nice little summary. Click Next. And green check mark completed successfully, which is always a good thing. Click Close. Awesome. Go to that testing machine. And you should notice that within the notification, it is saying from the software center that it is deploying or downloading and installing the software, which is a good sign. Let's head back into our SCCM console or server or whatever. Go into the monitor tab, go into deployment, and then locate your deployment. My deployment was called Microsoft Teams. There it goes. I'm going to right-click on it. And then click on View Status. Within here, we're going to click on the In Progress tab, and that's the machine that we just, you know, looked into. It's being downloaded and installing, which is a good thing. Awesome. Now, if you head back into your testing machine and you go into the C drive Windows CCM cache, you should see a new folder that popped up because it needs to drop it in here to cache and then to deploy it. So that's another confirmation. Another confirmation is if you open up the software center on that machine, you should see a new application being advertised to that machine. Awesome. If you go inside the installation status, it's another indication or confirmation that it is downloading or installing. Awesome. So hopefully you guys enjoy this video and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.